And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Beverly.
Last year's Warriors and where they ranked in the NBA. A chance to check that out now, Kevin. First in scoring. First in assist. And they also were number one in team shooting percentage. A very impressive offensive group.
And when you score like these guys did last season, it gives you tremendous confidence. Just play solid defense and you can win games.
Curry against Beverly. Curry kicks to Green, and it is flushed down with a nice jam.
You know, there are a lot of bigger power forwards than him in the NBA, but very few that rise up like he can.
For Houston, they've gone 6-10 from the field in this ballgame. Here's Beverly. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Pass to Howard. Dishes it to Monte Unis. Ariza goes in. No luck. And it's the Warriors taking it the other way. Now Barnes. The shot by Thompson and no one's around. And the go-ahead bucket, no good. Here's Ariza. Rebounded by Bogut.
Well, what appeared to be an easy 2 points just never materialized.
Green with the ball. Out left to the wing. Thompson, left side. The 9-foot shot. And it's Thompson again missing. Houston in the lead. Harden outside. Feeds it to Beverly. Pass to Monte Unis. Nice D from Bogut.
And guys, one thing that we were treated with last year was Steve Kerr's great quotability in post-game interviews and pressers. He said all the right things and deflected praise like a coach who had done it for many years.
Now here's Curry after Monte Unis' miss. Here's Thompson. And that was... One comes up a bit short.
His touch has disappeared on him this quarter. He just hasn't been able to get it going.
Harden gets to Monte Unis. Tries to snap the cold streak. He lays it in. Monte Unis has got his second bucket tonight. And Kerr is so good with the media because, Greg, he was a media member himself for so long. You know that as well as anybody. Clark, I don't think he ever tried his hand at broadcasting, though. I can't see him doing that, could you?
Yeah,
I know.
Right. He probably just drone on as a broadcaster and would rarely contribute anything of note. Some guys have what it takes to call games, and Steve just doesn't quite scratch me as that kind of guy.
No. Houston making some changes. Capella's checked in, and it's Beasley in for Monte Unis. And now the first timeout call here for the Rockets.
And guys, Dwight Howard's an interesting guy, one of the most physically imposing players in our league, and yet he's known for his lighthearted, almost playful nature.
And the Warriors with some changes. Spates comes in for Andrew Bogut, and it's Iguodala in for Barnes. And a change for the Rockets. Brewer is checked in for James Harden. Now here's Ariza, the wide-open look here for Terry. Connects from three-point range.
Jason Terry.
Terry's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. And for Howard, his parents raised him to keep a smile on his face and stay upbeat and remain positive. He's done all those things and still competed in the rough and tumble world of pro basketball.
Yeah, and yet some of it.
Oh!
Come on now, young fella. Watch out. You might bring that whole basket down on top of
it. I didn't think he was ever going to let go of the rim.
I tell you what, though, you might as well enjoy the moment. Make it last just a little longer.
That was a nice replay brought to you by Kia. Warriors trail by 4. Now here's Thompson. Outside Curry takes a 3. It's rebounded by Houston.
And you know what? He's just not on his game. No doubt about it. They're deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team.
It's Ariza on the wing. Releases. From the wing and drills it.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
The feed to Green. Spates with a screen on Beast. On the wing, Thompson. He makes that one drop, only a second and five tries. Rockets leading by four. And there's Terry. Beasley sets a screen for Terry. Pass to Beasley. Puts it up from 12. Great tee that time from Green.
And that was a difficult shot from mid-range simply because the defense was engaged.
Yeah, and I think the quickness of the closeout really threw him off. There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
Curry against Terry. And it's sent back by Spates. He lobs up the alley-oop pass, and Andre Iguodala with the slam.
A little bit of a magic act here, pulling off the Houdini to make that catch and slam.
Stupendous, stupendous alley-oop.
I think the crowd is still stunned by that one. And Andre Iguodala, guys, one of the most unselfish players in the league. I mean, that unselfishness for me, too, is what was put to a test.
Come on, fellas, we got to pick up the pace. If you see an open look, you got to take it. Have to make them play at our tempo.
You know what, he did it without complaint, putting the team first.
Timeout called, the Rockets. And for Iguodala, some have said he's unselfish, Clark, to a fault.
Yeah, and you know, a great athlete and ball handler, I think he could be much more aggressive looking to attack off the dribble. He's really unique, though, a player who puts his emphasis on the defensive end and does a really good job at that end of the floor.
McDaniels is checked in for Trevor Ariza. .136 left here in the opening quarter. Back to Beasley and stolen by Spates. On the wing, it's Iguodala. Terry covering. Iguodala kicks to Curry. Another three for Golden State.
Wow, what a special performance this guy's putting on from long range.
Well, that has been his shot today. No ifs, ands, or buts about.
Out of bounds, Golden State takes possession. .110 left to play here in the first. Clark, this offense has really been clicking.
No doubt about it, giving the defense all kinds of trouble.
And they know it, guys. They're playing right now with the kind of energy that is hard to deal with. Well, go ahead then and just hammer it home, why don't you?
He might not be the athlete that some of the other big men are in this league, but my goodness, he still knows how to finish.
Well, he doesn't count on elevation or hang time, that's for sure, but he can still get it in the basket.
Thompson outside for the three, and the Warriors get it back outside for Curry, and it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. Curry's got 14 points for the game.
Boy, has he put his foot on the pedal here this quarter. He's doing a terrific job in terms of leading their offense.
8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. The pass to Brewer to stop the run. Now in the scoring column with that deuce. 1 for 2 this game. There's 14 seconds left in the first quarter. Up top, Curry, covered by Brewer. Lets it go from deep, and he gets it to go. And that's 17 points for Steph Curry.
He's got some serious momentum going right now. He's been great all.